Once the model is created and tested, we can use the code generator. Code generation is a fairly broad topic that would take a little more time. In this section, we'll see only a small part of its potential, just to understand how it can be easy, in an integrated environment, to obtain and check the code always having as starting reference the Simulink model. We always start with the state machine model for BMS. To produce code generation, we can choose the embedded code wrap or from the bottom right corner, enter the code perspective, very similar to the requirement perspective. In this case, however, we'll open different windows. The first one is the code mapping, where we can choose for all inputs, all outputs, all global parameters, states, etc., etc., the storage class, which will change as groups the way they are declared in the code. If instead we want to work on the single elements, the model data editor in the code view will give us the possibility to do it. In the toolbar for code generation, there are many utilities that can help us. One of the most important is the code generator advisor that I recommend you to use. He will help you set the right code generator setting for your goals. When we generate code with this button, at the end of execution, we can see the code together with the Simulink design in one integrated view. This will make it much easier for us to understand what happened. We can see all the generated .c and .h files and simply hover the mouse over the code or model to see the links between them. If you want the reports, we can easily create and explore them for a simple using of a web view. For example, here we can see the number of code lines, the memory occupation of the single variables or structures, even at function stack level. Navigation is also possible in the report by simply clicking on the created web template. An important point is that the code is linked to the requirements. You see that here there is an hyperlink that indicates the link. This was created automatically because we had previously created the link between model and requirements. The link is bidirectional. So, through this icon here, we can also go from requirements to code. Among the apps, we can also open the IEC certification kit, which includes a series of artifacts which can open with this button. For example, for embedded code that we use to generate the code, we can open the TÜV certificate that indicate that the code generator is suitable for use to develop safety-related software and is qualified tool according to ISO 26262, but we also have other supporting artifacts that indicate for each table of ISO 26262 the use of the workflow and the individual tools for each specific topic indicated in the table on the various ASIL levels of safety. Going back, we also have the possibility to create the traceability metrics between code and requirements an artifact required by the certification, and that would be long to create manually.